Applications of thermodynamic. Okay, some of thermodynamic applications. The first one is like we'll be seeing about some vapor power cycles. Okay, the important vapor power cycle is nothing but the Rankine cycle. The later part in this second in the same session, in the second part, we'll be seeing about the refrigeration cycle. Okay, vapor power cycle. A simple vapor power cycle is something like. One second, guys. Yeah, a simple vapor power cycle will be something it look like sleep, look like this. From the boiler, okay, here that working medium is nothing but the steam, guys, okay. Here the working, you should, whatever I taught you in the properties of steam, everything will be working here, okay. The properties of steam means I have taught you about that saturated line, dry saturated line, and wet saturation line, right? Everything I have taught you in the previous lecture, just remember that, that will be applicable here, okay. In the simple, a simple steam power plant, okay, a simple steam power cycle will look like this. Okay, in the steam power cycle, that the components are nothing but a cooling tower. It contains a cooling tower and turbine and feed pump and boiler. Okay, here in the boiler, okay, in the boiler, heat is added to the system. Okay, heat is added, heat addition is happens in the boiler. Okay, then once after the heat is added, the steam is like superheated or dry saturated, whatever it is. Once the steam attains the heat, okay, then it is adiabatically expanded in the turbine. Okay, expansion is happening in the turbine. From that, they can produce the work. The turbine will produce the work. After it is like after it is expanded, okay, after it is expanded, then the steams are condensed. Okay, because the steams are after expanded, the steams are condensed. Once it is once the steams are condensed and cooled, okay. Then the water, okay, the steams are condensed, steams are like the steams condensed means we'll be getting a wet steam. What's wet steam? Or like at the end we'll be getting at a saturated steam, okay, then which is almost like water, okay. That thing is like feed it to the boiler again. This is a complete cycle of a simple steam power plant, okay. Since it's a kind of heat engine, okay, because its substance are undergoing in a cycle. Here the substance are nothing but water, okay. For a closed cycle, I told you from thermodynamics first law, sigma q is equal to sigma w, okay. Therefore, q1 minus q2 is nothing but heat added minus heat rejected is nothing but the net work done. That is WT, turbine work minus pump work. You got it, right? So efficiency of the cycle is nothing but net work done divided by heat supplied, which is WT minus WP divided by q1, which is again q1 minus q2 divided by q1, which is 1 minus q2 by Q1. It is simple. It's like a simple steam power cycle. Okay. Now let us go and look into the Rankine cycle. The same. What is a Rankine cycle means? The same, guys. The same. What are the example I have given here, right? That is called it's a Rankine cycle. Here, the simple. I know the diagram of Rankine cycle is shown in the figure. Okay. The heat is added at the boiler, which is the heat addition is happens in the boiler. Then the work. Once after the heat addition. Okay, from the turbine we'll be extracting the work. Okay, expansion is happening in the turbine. Once the steam is expanded, then the steam is condensed. Okay, the condensation is happening. The third process is condensed. After the steam is condensed, that you know the pump. Okay, once the finally the steam is condensed, right? The pump will supply the water to the boiler again. So this is the complete cycle. You got it, right? So let me show the TS diagram of this particular cycle. Okay, so at first what happens? At first from 4 to 1 heat is added. Okay, heat is added from the boiler. One second, guys. Yes, so let us try the PV diagram. Okay, if you see the PV diagram, you will be able to get it. Okay, so process 1 to 2, to see this process, the same PV diagram, let me draw it again here, the PV diagram. Okay, this is the PV diagram. This is how the properties of steam. If you see my previous thing, you will be understanding this. Okay, so from here, the turbine. Okay, so 1 double dash and 2 double dash is nothing but this is nothing but adiabatic expansion, reversible adiabatic expansion in the turbine. Okay, from here only the work is extracted. Okay, so I'm having 3 points, right? 3 points, 1 dash, 1, and here. I have shown the 3 points, right? The reason I have shown the 3 points, let me draw the diagram first, then let me explain it later. That will be like better. Yes. Okay. 1-1, 1-, 2-2, 2-, 3 and 4. Okay. Yes. Here, that 1-2, 2-, is nothing but adiabatic expansion in the turbine. Okay, adiabatic expansion means because of this expansion, okay, the work is produced from the turbine. Here, if you see that the 1-, during the that steam that is sent to the turbine is nothing but a superheated steam. You got it right, because the steam is above the dry saturated line, which is nothing but a superheated steam. Okay. So 1-, is nothing but superheated steam. From the if you see that from the expansion happens, so work is produced. Once it comes here, you got it right. The steam is like a wetted steam. Okay. So if you see the dryness fraction of here, it is more than like 0.85. Okay. Here the condensation happens. After condensed in the latent heat of the steam is reduced, then it will come to the 0.3. At 0.3 means it is like a fully saturated steam, like fully saturated, which means we will get water here. After condensation, we'll get the water. Then using feed pump, we'll be increasing the pressure of this pressure of the water. So using feed pump, the process goes from H3 to H4. The pressure increase from H3 to H4. Then at constant pressure, that heat is added to the system at constant pressure. Okay, this is what the system of Rankine cycle. Now the 0.1 means that the steam is allowed to expand. The input to the steam to the turbine is given at dry saturated. Okay, this is like dry saturated steam. The reason is that because like the input to the steam is given in the turbine in the dry saturated line. Now 1-1, if you see the input is given in the wet steam itself. So this is nothing but wet steam line. Okay. Let me tell you the reason and everything in the later point. Okay, this is what the process of Rankine cycle. By steady flow energy equation, already I taught you steady flow energy equation. So let us go using the steady flow energy equations, things. So for a boiler, what is the steady flow energy equation of the boiler? H4 plus Q is equal to H1, which tells me that Q is equal to H1 minus H4. Okay, similarly in turbine, apply steady flow energy equation only for the turbine. If you apply the steady flow energy equation for the turbine, plus H1 is equal to W2 plus H2, which tells me that W2 is nothing but H1 minus H2. Guys, just remember my first lecture in first law of thermodynamics, then you will follow this, okay? Then in the condenser. In the condensers, use the steady flow energy equation. You will see that H2 is equal to Q plus H3, which give me Q2 is equal to H2 minus H3. Similarly, for the pump, from H3 plus WP is equal to H4, which tells me that WP is equal to H4 minus H3. Okay, so these are like the steady flow energy equations for boiler, turbine, condenser, and pump. Now we see that efficiency of cycle is nothing but work done divided by heat supplied. Here, work done. Net work done is nothing but turbine power, which means work done by the turbine minus work done by the pump. That is the net efficient work. Okay, so WT is nothing but H1 minus H2 minus WP is nothing but H4 minus H3 divided by H1 minus H2. This is the efficiency of a Rankine cycle, guys. Okay, and for a steady flow energy equation, you see that the net work done is also nothing but minus integration of VDP as well. Okay, for already I have taught this thing in the first lecture itself. W is equal to minus integration of VDP, which tells me that H is equal to U plus TV. Okay, use this relation. So DH is equal to DU plus PdV. So DQ is equal to DU plus DW. Substitute this DU from here. So DU is equal to DH minus PdV minus VDP. Substitute this DU here, guys. To substitute that, we'll see that finally DQ is nothing but TdS, right? So using thermodynamic property, DQ is nothing but TdS, finally DdS is equal to DH minus VDP. It comes something like this. Okay, since DS is equal to zero, because at pump, you see that in see the TS diagram in the pump. So here in the pump, it happens at adiabatic compression. Okay, it's a kind of we are increasing the temperature. The process is adiabatic. So here the entropy is zero, guys. Change in entropy is zero for adiabatic process. See the TS diagram. It's a straight line. Okay, it is nothing but reversible adiabatic pumping process. Okay, it's adiabatic pumping process. Therefore, we can say that DS is equal to zero, which tells me that simply DH is equal to V into DP. Okay, the reason I'm explaining this derivation is like for work done by the pump, WP. For WP, simply we can use this formula. Okay, so work done by the pump is nothing but H4 minus H3, which is nothing but V into specific, V is nothing but specific volume, V into P4 minus P3. You got it, right? This is the work done by the pump. Take down the formula. This simply work done by the pump means we can get this formula easily by V into P4 minus P3. If you know the pressure, two pressures, upper pressure and lower pressure, P4 and P3, then we can use this formula and get the work done by the pump. You got it, right? So this V is nothing but the specific volume. The specific volume is nothing but inverse of the density. So this formula is again rewritten as 1 by rho into P4 minus P3. So this is work done by the pump. You got it, right? So the different thermodynamic relations of a Rankine cycle, okay, in TS diagram, HS diagram, and PV diagram. This HS diagram already I told you, it's a very famous diagram, which is nothing but Mollier chart. Okay, Mollier chart. A steam chart. So using this steam chart, we can get the any properties of a steam. Okay, this since the working medium here is steam, so this is the HS diagram of a simple Rankine cycle. Just note the HS diagram. Similarly, this is TS diagram and our PV diagrams.